Hello everybody, it's Eva from Bohemian Crafting back again. Today I'm coming to share with you a little bit different video than I normally do. Friends of mine, she asked me if I would like to join her on summer fair, which school of her son it's going to set up. And I said yes, because I never was on something like summer fair or craft fair or Christmas fair. So I was thinking what I will prepare for the, what kind of products I will prepare, and what I know from videos from ladies, that there is always better to have something easy for a small price. So I was thinking to do something from stuff I've got and something fast where I will don't use so much products, and which will be really fast to do. So I created those cute photo books, and what I used for those photo books, I already have three of them, and it's a very fast project, and I didn't use so much products. I used one file folder like this. It's window file folder. It's like pocket. It's from Craft Paper. I found it on eBay. The package was looks like this. It was 100 those file folders in one pack. It's called Forever Recycled Paper. All these looks like that. They are mixed of colors, and probably this is a company who made them. And here you've got name of these file folders. I found it on eBay, so I used one of these file folders. Then I used 8 papers 6x6, 8 of them, and then I used one clear bag for that packaging. And this clear bag, it's 5x7 inches, 5x7, and it's self-seal craft bag. I found it on the Works shop here in Rotterdam. So that's what I used, which is not too much, right? And then I used tacky glue for gluing those papers. So I will try to show you what I made. It's a really easy project. It's fast, and all this was what I used for creating that mini photo folder. And the size of this, it's great for 4x6 photographies. It has pocket. You don't have to do those pockets if you don't want. And it has 3 pockets here with 3 tags. And yeah, of course, I used also 3 cards. 3 7/8x6 inches long, 3 of them for those tags in those cards. That's all I used. So this file folder, it's 2 1/4 inch long and 8 3/4 inch wide. I took my guillotine and I cut 2 pieces 6 inches wide. So first 6, second 6, and I've been left with this small piece. I took first piece, and because I would like to have inside this clear frame, I know it will doesn't be probably seen, but I would like to have it inside, and also here, this corner, it's not a straight corner, and I would like to have that corner glued down there. So I fold it inside, like this, to that middle fold. And I put glue here on one side, that short one. Glue here and here. And I glue it. Then I fold that other half to that spine. And again, I put glue here, and here, I took that second piece. Oh, before I took that second piece, I took this leftover. Where is opening? I put glue. Here we've got two-page booklet with pockets here. So I put glue where is spine of that booklet. Just small amount of glue. And with this opening, oops, with this opening here, I place it to the edge of this booklet. Go to that end. Then I took that second piece and I did exactly the same. I fold that first half to the middle. Put glue here and here. Took another half, fold it again to that spine. Put glue here. This is a wonderful project now in the end of school year for teachers, like a gift. Maybe for Christmas fair. It's fast. You can use those 6x6 paper pads which you have in your stuff. You can use 12x12 and cut it on, you know, on those pieces you will need. It's really fast. Then I put glue here on this small piece. Oops. Here I've got pockets. And in this booklet, I've got pockets here. I have to make sure that it's opening here. So with that spine, I glue it on that piece here. And I've got a small book with 4 pages. With size 4 1/4, a little bit more than 1/4 by 6, which is brilliant for 4x6 photographies. Then I took those 6x6 papers, 8 of them. I cut them to the size 4 1/4, all of them. 8 papers, and I cut them to size 4 1/4. So I've got 2 pieces. Once I have all those 8 pieces cut to 4 1/4 by 6, so I made position where I would like to have them in that book, you know, to match those papers together. So I place them to that position. Here I've got my leftovers, I'm gonna use them. And then I started to glue here where is my frame. I took those pieces out to place them on the side, and then I just took that rest, I put glue, and I start to glue them on that pages. All 6 of them which I've got here. This was really very fast, so just put glue on those sides. No any pockets, because this will be for normal people, not for crafters. So many pockets can be for confusing, and this should be fast project for craft fair or for some summer fair. So this way I glued those pages on my pages. Like this, just glue those pages on your pockets. I've got pockets here, pocket here. So now I'm gonna take those 2 pages, which I would like to have here on the front, like a frame on that window. And luckily I have a die for to make that window. So I'm gonna use die. I'm gonna make a position somewhere where it's that acetate piece, which is really pretty big space, so I'm okay with that. So I'm gonna cut some frame inside using some frame die. If you've got square die or that other piece, that longer square, I forgot again the name of that, not square, that longer square, I forgot, what is it, I'm sorry, but I think you know, that frame die, just use it, cut that frame, like this. I forgot to tell you, I hold it, those pieces, the way they will be in that book, to make sure that those frames will be on same position. So I cut two frames, then I took that liquid glue and I glue it on that piece. First. First here, and as you can see, that frame is a little bit bigger. That's why then I used those leftovers and I start to decorate that frame this way, even from inside, like cut pieces and decorate it with layers. So I'm gonna glue that second piece as well inside, like this. And now I'm going to choose which paper, I'm gonna first choose which paper I would like to have like those tabs on the side here. So I'm gonna choose from those leftovers, which I would like to have there. And why do not do pinks? I think I'm gonna use this with pink color. So I'm gonna cut this piece. This leftover, which is 1 1/4 by those 6. So I'm gonna cut it on 3 pieces, 2-inch long, like this. Three similar pieces, 2 inches by 1 1/4. I'm gonna take those 3 pieces and I'm gonna fold those 2 inches long sides together. Those 2 inches together so that 1 3/4 inch side it's folded on half. And now I need to use some corner punch or some decorative punch to create my tabs. Luckily I have envelope punch, this one. So that was what I used for my tabs. I just created this way the tabs for my photo booklet, all of them. Like this. Then I took my book. I took one tab and I made position here. I hope I don't have it upside down. I do have it upside down. Okay, I'm gonna make position from. I'm gonna take last page and I'm gonna try to make position. Oh, about 1/8 inch from the bottom and here to make it straight with this edge, to copy that edge with this fold. Hopefully I'm okay. It's a little bit in angle and I glue it here. Then I took another piece, because this has some writing, I have to make sure that it will be not upside down. And I opened this second, not this first front, but that second pocket or page. And again, I glue it about 1/8 inch from the start. I place it on my page like this. Here I try to make it, you know, again, copy this edge with this fold. I put glue from that other side and fold it. Then I took third piece. Where is that writing? Isn't it upside down? This way. Okay. I took that third piece. I put glue on that third piece a little bit. And I tried to make position just between to make sure that it will be between. It will be somewhere here. You know, it will be like end from here, start from here. So I made position. I think I'm right, hopefully. So that was my tabs. Yay! And it looks amazing. I love those tabs. And now, because here it's that, you know, that color, that very lilac color, it can be seen there. And I was thinking you can end up with this one. You've got beautiful spaces for photographies, and you've got pockets here, so you can add there just, you know, cards with toppers. I'm gonna do it straight away. I'm gonna choose two of these leftovers for my toppers. So I guess something without writing, what can be, you know, this way. This has writing, so I can choose from these three. And I think I would like to have this and this. One, two, three cards. So I've got three cards, 4 7/8 by 6 inches. They are all same. I'm gonna cut this on 4 7/8. Oh, for 3 7/8. I'm sorry, not 3 7/8. These are 3 7/8 as well. Not 4. I'm sorry. 3 7/8. So I'm gonna cut this on 3 7/8 as well. That second piece as well. 3 7/8, like this. I'm gonna fold those two pieces. Like this. One and second. Just fold these on the half. You can score it, you know, and fold it after you scoring in middle, but because this paper, it's not strong, I can just fold it. Now I'm going to use that envelope punch, and I'm gonna cut those edges as well. Again, you can use some decorative scissors, decorative corner punches to create toppers for your tabs or those inside cards, like this. And I took first one. And I place it on my card. You know, through to that light, I saw if this is straight. Like this. And I try to match again that fold with this edge to make it straight. And I've got first tack or photo mat. And I did same with that second one, like this, two choppers. Then I took that third card and I cut the ends on that card as well. And I think I will have to cook them a little bit down. So. First pocket. I'm gonna try if is it free. So we've got first tack. Open, open, open. We've got second tack. And we have third one here. Like this, it's like cascade. And now I can create pockets here if I will want so. So I will again just choose the papers I would like to have there. Probably this one here. Here probably. This one. Yes, this one. And here. This I will use for decorating those pieces. So I need a piece of paper to cover those fuchsia colors. For that I'm gonna choose, here I will have to have some different one. So I guess I'm gonna put a very dramatic pocket here. And I'm gonna choose this strip paper here. So I'm gonna cut this window, it's 3 inches. 3 inches wide like this. So I'm gonna cut this one on 3 inches. And then I'm gonna cut half inch strip, I think. 2 strips for each side. One, two, half inch. So I've got 2 strips, 3 by 1/2 inch. I'm gonna put one here. I'm gonna cover that fuchsia color. Another one here. Oops, that's when you fold it in your hand, right? Hey, go down, go down. Like this. I think here I will choose this like decoration. So again I will use this leftover and I'm gonna put again 2 strips 1/2 inch wide. 1, 2. We've got this leftover. One will be here. I'm gonna match that window edge. I'm gonna try to keep this distance same from the end. I'm gonna place the same piece from that other side. Like this. And now if I will want, I can create those pockets. I did create those pockets just I just folded those pieces on the half. I put glue, just small amount of glue in this fold to keep it, you know, keep it in that fold. And first I glued that piece in that fold. Like like this, and I let it dry. Once it was dry, I put glue here on those sides, and I've got two pockets, you know, put glue here, 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 and I've got two pockets from here, and I did same from with pockets here, exactly same. And then I just used that leftover for finishing decorating those two windows and one piece, which I've got here. I took my decorated, fully decorated, so here are leftovers, which you can use for decorating. And from that window, I've got two cards, which I can use in those pockets. I can put them, but once I will have there some pockets, I can place those pictures to those pockets. Then I took this piece, I place it to that back. I seal it. I folded that last piece and I glue it on the top, and I cut that leftover with my scissors. That was all I made. I used also white cardstock to, you know, to do some decorating. But it was really fast, and I really like this project. It was fast, and I can use, you know, those file folders I bought. I wanted to see they was for a good price, so I bought them. But that fuchsia color, it's very bright. So that's why I'm covering all that piece, and I'm leaving just those edges here and here. And I think it's cute. So this is my sharing for today. I hope you will take some inspiration. This is really very fast, and it was made 100 times for file folders, so it's nothing new. It's just my sharing. If you will have those window pocket folders, so if you will have them, just use that window to make window on your mini photo books. So this is my sharing for today. I hope you enjoy. I hope you took some inspiration. Thank you so much for sharing your time with me today. Have a wonderful day, and see you next time. Bye.